Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
When you are on WhatsApp. Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
When you are on Facebook. Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
Before boss comes. Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
When you are talking to the boss.
When you are talking to the boss.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
After boss goes.
After boss goes.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
When your wife is boiling.
When your wife is boiling.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
When your wife is cool.
When your wife is cool.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
When your husband is boiling.
When your husband is boiling.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
When your husband is silent.
When your husband is silent.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
When you watch the TV.
When you watch the TV.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
When you are going to sleep.
When you are going to
sleep. Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
When you are dreaming.
When you are dreaming.
Watch the belly.
Watch the belly.
Wash the belly,
wash the belly.
All the time,
all the
time. To stay in the present.
To stay in the present.
To tie the monkey
to
the pole. Is it clear? So now what happens is this practice, if you make it, in dream also you'll get awareness. Okay? All your bad dreams, everything, again you astrology the belly, all the dreams will disappear.
It is a daydream or actually sleeping?
Sleeping dream also. No? In sleeping dream, what comes? Your day-to-day practice only will come now. You don't need to practice it. It will become automatic. Right? So in dream also, this practice will trigger. So gradually, all your dreams will wash off. All subconscious impression will wash off. So I am teaching you my method by 24 hours a day, you can be in Atma. Is it simple?
Didityasa
has two aspects, no? While working and while samadhi. So I am telling you practice which will help you search samadhi.
Once you think about belly, other thoughts fail to come.
Correct. The idea is to take your mind to the present moment. In the present moment, who is witnessing? Sakshi, Atma. Right? So if you understand this, this practice will help you. Are we clear now? Is it simple?
Yeah.
No complexions? Right? So you will get many occasions when husband is boiling or wife is boiling and great occasions to go back to Atma. Right? Let us start now. Let us close your eyes and observe the belly. Moves up, moves down, and pause in between. Pause is Sakshi. Moves up, Sakshi knows. Moves down, Sakshi knows. Pause. Sakshi only is there. So I am beyond birth and death. Now, asatoma
asatoma
sadgamaya
sadgamaya
tamasoma
tamasoma
jyotirgamaya
jyotirgamaya
mrityorma
mrityorma
amritam gamaya
amritam gamaya
om shanti shanti shanti
om shanti shanti shanti
lokaah samastaah
lokaah
Sukhino bhavantu
Sukhino bhavantu
Harihi Om
Harihi Om
Shri Gurubhyo Namaha
Shri Gurubhyo Namaha
Harihi Om
Harihi Om
That's okay. So everybody did it? Find peaceful? Everybody, you can go to peace at any point of time. Okay? I don't have peace in life is not an excuse. The peace is in your belly. Now you become a belly boy or belly girl. And observe the belly dance. As simple as that. Right?
That inhaling, exhaling could be... Should be
natural, no disturbance, no changes.
What he means is perhaps he is automatically trying to force it. Perhaps.
Don't force it. Yeah. Don't force. Just
when it is natural, there is no movement at times.
No, it will be there. When it's natural, the moment starts. Moment, slow moment. Then moment will become slow. Okay, and sometimes it may stop. That's okay. But don't do any force.
That force, deep breathing and all. Voluntarily you push the stomach.
Who is that voluntarily doing? Sakshi is becoming doer now. Why should Sakshi become doer? Sakshi has to become Sakshi. Right? So you should not do any effort. Effortlessly observe. Is it clear? Mind becomes peaceful? Deeply? So now let us do the same thing with open eyes. I am just giving you both open eyes and closed eyes because most of the time we have to live with open eyes. Right? So, with open eyes also you can do this practice. Let's do it. Stop practice. Are you getting everybody?
Right? It's better this time, Guruji.
Yeah.
See, initially, I tended to close my eyes every time.
No, not required. Required. So, as you practice, with eyes open, you feel the peace. Right? Even the stress is going, with a lot of stress is around, you can feel the peace. Okay? Everybody understood this? Maitri? Ashwini? Raju?
Yes.
Right? So next step in this. This is not over. Next step in this is where is the breath rising and where is the breath falling? Can you please tell me? Where is the breath rising and where is the breath falling?
It is rising.
falling.
Yeah, where is it rising and where is it falling?
I think in the name.
Chest. When we are taking in breath, it is falling.
When oh, you taking the breath also? Our breath is moving.
When the breath is going inside.
Okay. Where is the breath rising and where is the breath falling?
Breath is moving in the belly is rising.
Ashwini?
Not able to figure out.
Raju?
I think it's going to the heart.
Thank God, it's not going to kidney. she is okay. She's listening to too many of my talks. Where is the breath rising and where is breath falling?
I think it's starting from here and going.
See, here and there are related to mind. So, breath is rising in consciousness and falling back in consciousness. So, you are calling it belly, you are calling it name actually. There is a one moment in consciousness which is rising and falling. Is it not in your consciousness?
Yeah.
Yes. In witness, it's rising and falling.
Yes.
Are you clear? So there is a moment in consciousness rising and falling. Rising from consciousness, going back to consciousness. Alright? Two monks were fighting. The flag was fluttering. The monk once said, flag is fluttering, because flag is fluttering. So three monks. So the second monk said, shut up, the flag is not fluttering, wind is making the flag flutter. The guru came, shut up, your mind is fluttering. Right? So you are watching the belly, no. You are watching the movement of the mind. Who is watching the movement of mind? Sakshi. The mind is rising from Sakshi and going back to Sakshi. The belly movement is appearing in Sakshi and going back to Sakshi. Understand? The Sakshi is always the background.
Even rising and falling is also
not there. It's also not there. That's, he's got next step. Okay. It's a label only. So, there is a movement in consciousness. The movement in consciousness is called Shakti. Okay? Just now, you observed Adi Parashakti in motion. Shakti is with one with Shiva. She just moves and goes back. Just moves and goes back. So whatever you call as Adi Parashakti, in action is this breath. So the breath is moving from consciousness and going to consciousness. Are we clear now?
Sir.
Now, huh? Yeah.
So this movement, consciousness. So are they separate?
No. The movement is appearing in consciousness and going back to consciousness. So any movement in consciousness is unreal because consciousness doesn't move. So unreal movement is there in consciousness. That's next step.
Yeah, but still when I'm not coming out of the duality, maybe.
No.
He is asking the question. This appearance and then consciousness, both are separate.
No. He is asking the question: is appearance and consciousness, there's a duality or not? So who can answer this question? He is asking question: there is appearance of movement, appearance of the body, appearance of the world, and consciousness. Okay. So is there a duality? Ashwini. You don't know. Maitri?
I feel there is a duality. It's not there.
Why it's not there?
The duality is not there.
Why it's not there?
Because when everything is consciousness, the appearance is just coming. It's not separate or anything to make it a duality.
It's not separate from consciousness.
It is not separate from consciousness, number one. It rises from consciousness, goes back to consciousness. Okay, number one. Imagine. Number two, the definition of unreal is something which is there for some time, which is not there before, which is not there later. The consciousness is there in the beginning, in the middle, and the end. Whereas what appears in the middle and disappears is not real because it's just a momentary appearance. Okay? So that's why it's not real.
It is unreal. Okay.
Unreal. Okay?
But
We'll come to that. So then real and unreal, are is there a duality? Okay? Is there a duality called real and unreal?
You said unreal is...
Why? Maitreyi, my notary is saying no. Why?
Because even the unreal is part of the real
and unreal. Unreal is appearance in the real, not part.
No, it's everything is consciousness only.
Yes, everything is a consciousness, but consciousness doesn't move. It's infinite.
Uh-huh.
What is infinite cannot move. So there appears to be a moment which is not real. Okay, now you say duality is there, real and non-real duality is there.
Is unreal real?
Unreal real.
Is unreal
so, unreal and real, there is no duality because unreal is like a shadow. It follows you. Okay? So, unreal follows real like a shadow.
Sun is also required. No, then you there see? Is a shadow and there is a real.
Real. So, real so is shadow.
Body and shadow is
no,
unreal.
Shaker. Shaker has a shadow.
Yes. So okay. There is a shaker and there is shaker's shadow.
No, no. Shaker and shaker's shadow. Shaker's shadow doesn't exist independent of shaker.
Yes.
Right?
It will go and come also.
It will go and come also.
Day and night.
So, what is depend on shaker? Is it dual or non-dual?
Non-dual. So what is definition
non-dual.
Of dual? Dual means
there are two. Dual means two independent existence. There is no independent existence for the shadow. There is no real existence for shadow. Shadow is absence of reality. That's why shadow is there. Okay? Any movement in consciousness is absence of your observation. When your attention goes back to Atma, there is no world, there is no body, there is no mind. That happens in deep sleep. That happens in deep meditation. So the world is appearing because of your attention and ignorance. There's no duality at all. It's unreal.
You mean non-dual means it is two independent entities are not there. It is like
duality means two independent entities. Okay? If one entity is ornament, will only depend on gold. If gold is not there, there's no ornament. Okay? And ornament is not there, still gold is there.
Yes.
Right? So ornament is a shape and form of gold. Shadow is a shape and form of you. But it depends on you. Okay? Yes. And also it's absence of light. Shadow. So similarly, the world and body is absence of your awareness. Or your attention is going somewhere else. Okay? So let us go to the next step now. We have to understand the breath is rising from consciousness and going back to consciousness. Is this clear to all? So now, the breath makes a sound. Okay? Just make a little bit sound when you breathe in and breathe out. So what is the sound breath is making? Sir?
Out of friction.
Like
sound of
show me now, through mouth you make no sound. Okay, anybody else?
It's the moment.
What sound it's making?
The conscious or the sound, the awareness has gone
in there. No, you tell me, you make the sound or breath is making with the mouth. Maitreyi, what is the sound breath is making? Huh? No sound. What is sound?
The wind sound or when you keep the shell.
No, don't you explain, make the sound. Somebody asked me, aeroplane, okay? How aeroplane is going? I said, you tell me how what breath sound breath is making.
Peaceful sleep.
No, that's explanation. Make the sound and tell me. Again try.
Resistance.
Again try. Let's see.
Ha.
Okay. Fully do it again. This guy got it. Okay. So the breath is making so hum. You understand? So hum sound is naturally happening with breath. Understand? Okay? Everybody understood?
Yeah.
So what is so hum? What is soham?
I am that.
Maitreyi, what is soham? Saha?
Aham. Everything is...
No, saha means he.
He, okay.
Aham.
Aham, me.
Okay. Ashwini? Saha? You don't make this sound?
I'm not making that soham.
Make it now. Through throat.
You need to open your mouth and...
No, throat, your throat creates resistance. Okay? Saha
aham.
Saha aham. What it means?
Brahmasmi.
Shiva is Jiva. Okay? Shiva is Jiva.
Shaha's meaning is mind.
Saha means he. He means Shiva, consciousness, Brahman. Aham means I. The Brahman or consciousness, okay, has taken your body and enjoyed it, but he has kept an alarm clock. I am he. You understand? Who is suffering? Why the hell God created me? God himself is enjoying through your body. Okay, he has kept an alarm called I am he, soham. Are you clear? How many of you keep the alarm and don't wake up?
President
sleep. So daily 21,600 times Shiva has kept an alarm to wake up. Okay? Just to remind himself, okay? I am not this body, I am not Shiva. You have to remind, he has kept the alarm call 21,600 times through the breath. Okay? But after 21,600 times every day also, he is sleeping in Maya. You understand? Why? Why is so?
Ignorance is bliss.
No, ignorance. He is never ignorance. He has kept the alarm and slept. Huh?
We don't know that the alarm has been kept.
Who is we? Who is we? You mean to say Shiva doesn't know?
No, Shiva knows.
Who is you?
Okay. Yeah. I am Shiva.
So, I'll repeat. Na Gurur. Adikam tattvam Shiva shasanataha
na
guror Adikam tattvam
Shiva
shasanataha Shiva shasanataha Shiva shasanataha. So Shiva, before sleeping, he has kept a Shasana means a law. Shiva Shasanataha. This is actually Shiva, this thing, Guru Gita and Shiva. Shiva Shasanataha, Shiva Shasanataha, Shiva Shasanataha. It is three times. Na Gurur Adhikam Tattvam. There is no truth beyond the Guru. So the Shiva has to come in the form of Guru to wake up Shiva, who is in the form of asleep. Till that time of time, alarm will not go off. Are you getting it? Now I am telling you how to make the alarm work.
Guru is the alarm clock.
No, Guru is alarm. Now alarm, even if you may doze off, right? You may doze off now with alarm also. So make sure that now alarm is loudly heard. Guru is telling you. So repeat with me. Na Guru Radhikam Tattvam. Shiva Shasanataha.
Shiva Shasanataha.
Na Guru Radhikam Tattvam.
Na Guru Radhikam
Shivashasanatah.
Shivashasanatah.
Shivashasanatah. So the Guru will come to remind you that there's an alarm kept. Now wake up once and whenever the alarm goes off, don't go to sleep, again wake up. And the alarm is kept for 21,600 times a day. Every minute of time, whenever you are alive, that alarm is ringing. So never fall asleep to teach that Guru has to come. And Shiva, before taking the body form, he decided, Shiva alone will come in the form of Guru to wake up the Shiva who is asleep in the body. So that's why you heard this mantra soham many times, millions of times, right? Have you heard of that? And you have done the chanting also. But you didn't get the essence of the mantra. Okay? Until the Guru cracks the essence of mantra, the mantra will not be understood. Otherwise, you'll keep on saying soham, soham, soham. What soham, soham? What soham? You don't have to say soham. The soham is already there. Okay? The soham...
Soham meditation, they say.
They are all, they'll say.
So you don't... Ravi Shankar, they tell that.
No. That, how it has to be implemented in life, I'm telling you. Finally, see, doing meditation is not the purpose. Soham is a reminder for you that I am the Atma. You don't have to chant soham. You don't have to think soham. The moment you observe the breath, belly, soham is there. Now what it means is that consciousness from consciousness, the belly is rising, consciousness is a movement and going back. What is consciousness? Shiva. Understand? Are you clear what I'm saying? So again and again, you have to remember, again and again, the moment, belly movement is there, I am the witness. Witness is Shiva. This movement is happening in Shiva, which is Shakti. Shakti is one with me. Shivoham. Is this understood by everybody? Is it clear to you? Anybody didn't get clearly? Ashwini? Understood? So, when you observe the belly, you remember the sound, so, and you remember that you are witness, consciousness, and Sakshi, Shivoham, I am Shiva. You don't need to chant, no need to chant. And this mantra is called Ajapa mantra, Ajapa Japa. That means no mantra which cannot be chanted. Okay? There are a lot of practices where they say chant, Soham, Choham, it's all not correct. Ajapa Japa means mantra which is happening, you don't have to chant. Okay? The mantra is programmed by Shiva for you to remember your own nature. Any questions? Clear? So let us, with this understanding, our attention is on consciousness, Shivoham. In Shiva, not the belly, but I am Shiva. In the Shiva, there's a movement happening. Understand? Earlier I told you to observe the belly. Now I'm telling you, I am Shiva. In I am consciousness, which is silence and peace, in that belly movement is happening. Is there a difference? Is there?
Should we remember soham?
No. We should remember soham. So breath is soham. Breath is making soham. Right?
Rhythm itself is soham.
Attention should be still in the belly.
No. Attention is I am Shiva. As Shiva, I am observing the movement. So where is the attention now?
On Shiva.
Not on Shiva. I am Shiva. On Shiva means again Shiva will be somebody else. I am Shiva. I am consciousness. In me, there is a movement taking place. So attention is not in belly movement. Attention is I am Shiva. Shivoham. Soham. Are we clear? Understood? Everybody understood? Gayatri? Mamata? Maitri? Okay, let us do this thing with the understanding that Shivoham. And in Shiva there is a movement happening which is called Shakti. Shakti is not separate from me. That's it. In breath, out breath, and pause movement is there. Shivoham, I am Shiva, I am consciousness. I am Shiva, I am consciousness, infinite consciousness. Shivoham. Satoma,
Satoma,
Sadgamaya,
Sadgamaya.
tamasoma jyotirgamaya mrityorma amritam gamaya om shanti shanti shanti
om shanti shanti shanti
lokaha samastaha
sukhino bhavantu
hari om
hari om
shri gurubhyo namaha
Hari Om.
So everybody clear? Do you recognize how you are peaceful? The peace is your nature. The peace is called Shiva. Any questions, any doubts are there?
It is also like the three states of dreaming, waking and sleeping. The gap is a sleeping state. Breathing, rising and...
No. Gap is Turiya.
Okay. So we are in all the three states, Shiva, the consciousness is available.
Yes.
And the waking and this Maya is available.
Yes. So, is this clear? So, Shivoham, is it clear to you? Right? Shivoham.
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 Ramana Shivoham.
Ramana Shivoham.
Ramana Shivoham.
Ramana Shivoham.
Ramana
Shivoham. Ramana Shivoham.
Ramana Shivoham.
Okay. So again and again you have to remember Shiva. So for that your alarm clock is given, which is breath. Right? And what is the name of this meditation? And belly dance. This meditation is actually a real Soham meditation. Okay? Soham meditation is not saying Soham, Soham, Soham. Soham meditation is observing Soham, Soham. Alarm clock observation is called Soham meditation. Is it clear?
Attention shifts to the nose.
No. See, the idea is it is not nose or this thing. Attention is, I am Shiva, you have to go back to attention, you have to go back to consciousness.
But then you should have attention on the belly also.
No, see, it's like while sleeping, I am aware of the bed. So, the I am starting from consciousness, moving it, going back to consciousness. So, again, it's coming back to consciousness only now. The movement is happening in consciousness. So the reference is consciousness. Is this clear to everybody? Mm-hmm. Shall we go to the next step in this? Is the mind peaceful? Deeply silent? At any point of time you can get back to peace? Right? Okay. So let us go to the next step now. Next step in this is belly is moving. Okay? And with the belly, there is a slight movement in the whole body, from head to toe. There are small movement are happening. When the breath comes in, there is a movement in the body. The breath stops, the other movement stops. So now become aware of the belly, become aware of all the movements within the body, from head to toe. Rising from consciousness, going back to consciousness. Your reference should be consciousness. If you are getting lost, Shivoham will get you back to consciousness. Understand? So now, belly attention will be there, and with the attention of belly, throughout the body, small movement is taking place, head to toe. So now, what are you doing actually? You are observing the body. Now you are becoming proper observer of the body. Proper observer of the body is consciousness, Sakshi. And only belly, one part of the body is observing. Now, entire body you are observing, Sakshi, Shiva. Is everybody got this? Anybody didn't go? Please raise your hands. Okay, let us start. Breath is rising from consciousness. At the belly, movement is happening. Throughout the body, there is a movement is happening. And all movements are going back to consciousness. Shivoham. observe the small, small movements taking place in the body, rising and falling with the breath into consciousness. Asatoma, Satgamaya, Tamasoma, Jyotirgamaya, Mrityorma, Amritamgamaya, Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi,
Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi,
Lokaha Samastaha,
Sukhino Bhavantu,
Harihi Om, Shri Gurubhyo Namaha,
Harihi
Om. So, everybody is able to do this. What difference does it make? Is the mind peaceful for everybody?
Yeah.
Silent? You think your body is a solid thing. Every moment it is coming out of consciousness, just like a wave comes out of ocean, it goes back. Moment to moment your body is appearing and disappearing in consciousness. Understand? See, in deep sleep you go into consciousness and morning body appears. But in reality, you are not observed, understood what's happening with the breath. With every breath, you are merging back into consciousness. Every breath, you are coming out of consciousness. You think you are a solid entity as a body. You are not. You understood? You are consciousness. The body is appearing and going. Tuck, tuck, every moment.
Like consciousness.
Ah. It's appearing in consciousness like wave appears in ocean and dissolves in ocean. Wave appears and dissolves. Then how come you have the illusion that I am the body? Let's observe it.
Like in picture screen.
Movie. But now you, that's because you are attracted to the movie. Now you go back to the observation, what's happening, breath. So at that level, everything is happening, disappearing into consciousness, every moment to moment.
To capture that, when disappearing, it's very clear with the breath, coming, going. And the pause also. But with the body, it is
not. No, you have to become, gradually you have to spread your awareness to entire body. Entire body is appearing and dissolving. Appearing So it took us some amount of practice at home. So it just body is appearing and dissolving. Okay? Don't be ever under the impression that body is solid actually. And body has 80 kgs, that I know. That's weight. Body has no solidity, it's appearing and disappearing in consciousness.
That's sensation.
Sensations are just appearing and disappearing. Okay, when the self forgets itself, it thinks that they're solid.
So, if all this scheme of things, what is jiva doing?
You tell me, now you have heard everything, now you have to tell me.
I know that there will be the consciousness and that stuff, but then why is jiva created at all?
You tell me. Now you tell me, after hearing all this Ratri Allah Ramayana, Ramasidhika Ramayana.
Then
after that, you know, it's
Maya and all that.
See, somebody produces a movie, beautiful movie. What if there is no spectator? Watch Mali Jana, the movie at the end. So the movie is projected called Maya. Now the spectators are required. Who is the spectator? Yaru illale, Shivane. And he enters into the body to experience it. In the process of experiencing, he enjoys so much movie that he forgets that he is Shiva. That's jiva.
The unreal Shiva is jiva.
No. Real Shiva. Shiva only, jiva is only Shiva.
The consciousness is jiva.
Awareness
Shiva. Awareness is Shiva. Awareness identifies with the body is jiva. Why it's identified with the body? Because it's fascinated by the movie. Dance of Shakti. That's all, just enjoyment.
So, why? The words used in the scheme of things.
So, Ashini, did you understand? Is it clear? Why you are Shiva?
Yes.
Okay. So, what about you? Nimgaita, you clear it? Madam?
Movement of body is not.
Illala, nee yen madako, idanna practice madako. ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇನ್ನೂ ಎಲ್ಲ ಮೂಮೆಂಟ್ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತವೆ. ಅಲೆ ಆಗಿ ಬರ್ತವೆ ಹೋಗ್ತವೆ. ಈಗ ನಿಮಗೆ ಇಷ್ಟು ಅಷ್ಟು ಮಾಡ್ಸೋಕ್ಕೆ ಟೈಮ್ ಇಲ್ಲ ಇಲ್ಲಿ. ನಿಮಗೆ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದೇನೆ, ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಇಟ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಅಪಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ವೇವ್ ಗೋಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ರೈಟ್. ಇನ್ನು ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್ ಶಾರ್ಪ್ ಆಗಿ ಇನ್ನು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಈಗ ಕಂಡುಬಿಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಾ, ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ನಿಧಾನವಾಗಿ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಮಾಡಕ್ಕೆ. ಡಿಡ್ ಯು
ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್?
No, that's because you are still, you require practice. That much practice I can't do it here. Right? As you become more and more aware, you'll see everything, body is appearing like a ripple appears. Then ripple dissolves.
You're talking like a Star Trek, no? The person comes in. I mean, button they come.
But that's the whole thing is, the beauty is it's happening moment to moment. You are thinking your body is solid. Every moment you are creating, dissolved.
Seems to be fiction till it is realized.
No, you observe it. You only observe it. Your own body, you observe it. So you are not observing your body, you are observing through the body. That's the problem. So Maitri, you understood? What did you observe?
I didn't get that getting the particles and going back and coming.
Not particles, movement.
I didn't get
that. So, you do it. This practice, you do it along the Upasana, then you will see everything, body getting assembled and disassembled.
So you are talking like quantum physics, no? Like this is all form, not a particle. So that everything is in vibration.
That's exactly what's happening. You are duped into believing that you are a body. Okay, shall we go to next practice? Is this practice clear? There are some more steps in this practice. But I think we'll stop it here. First, you practice this much?
Yeah.
Okay.
You have to get dematerialized. This process is kind of materializing and dematerializing.
And every moment it's happening.
And every second, yeah.
Every second. Okay, so probably when you come to senior batch, I'll tell you more practices of this particular thing.
Did we all automatically move to the senior batch?
No, that's a test exam actually. There's a test, if you pass the test, Okay, only who are actually claiming that they are Shiva can be admitted.
Sample question.
Claiming.
Yeah, there will be some questions will be there. Tricky questions will be there.
Explain his exam.
Okay.
Question paper is there?
Sample question.
Record the question.
Okay. So.
Optional or multiple choice.
Actually.
Multiple choice.
I, there is no answer actually. The moment I ask the question, I can see, read the answer in your face actually. The whole your body answers actually. To know whether they are this person is answered or not.
It's not mouth.
It's not mouth or written. The moment I ask the question and look into the people's eyes and faces, I understand. Okay, answer is there.
I speak more than no.
The whole body speaks actually. See, this is actually, for me, this is the fun, real fun I am having in teaching. I can see the subtle changes in each of your bodies, faces. This is my entertainment program. Other than Netflix. Okay. So, let us go to next practice, right?
No talk today.
Huh? No talk?
There is no talk today.
What talk? This is talk only, no? Did I talk? Didn't I talk?
Practice.